مرحبا واهلا وسهلا فيكم. This is Ibrahim with you. Welcome to our new session of learning Arabic idioms part 3. Well, Arabic idioms, why we're learning Arabic idioms. Arabic idioms, they make everyday life because we tend to use them literally every time. People kind of meet each other and then somebody would bring up a topic and then people start using these idioms to refer to the general meaning or to refer to it. But obviously to the naked eye or to the non-native speaker, that kind of doesn't mean anything unless you know the equivalent that we have it in English or in our native tongue. So I'll try to give you the Arabic, try to give you the nearest meaning in English, and if there is an idiom similarly that we have in English, but don't forget if you've got the same in your own language, let me know. Great, and our first idiom is عدم الجواب جواب. عدم الجواب جواب. And the literal translation for it means no answer is an answer. And it means silence speaks volumes. You know, when do we use it? So it's commenting on a similar situation. That way people tend to use it, but obviously to the naked eye or to the new learner or newcomer to the language, it isn't clear. So here we go, hopefully be able to use it. Great, our second idiom is حرسوا القط على اللبن. حرسوا القط على اللبن. Sometimes they put الحليب. And the literal translation for it means they left the cat to guard the milk. And we do have something similar in English, which means they set the wolf to guard the sheep. And similarly, we do have it with William Shakespeare and the two gentlemen of Verona when he says, Las, poor Petronius, thou hast entertained a fox to be the shepherd of thy lambs. So here we go. And in Arabic, we say, حرسوا القط على اللبن. حرسوا القط على اللبن. Our third and final idiom is ضرب الحبيب زبيب. ضرب الحبيب زبيب. And it means beating by a loved one. Are as sweet as raisin or is sweet as raisins. I'm not really sure if that might be the case. But that's what we say in Arabic. And obviously, we do have something that was written by Richard Edwards around 1523, which is the falling out of a faithful friend's renewing is of love. And with that, I'll end today's tutorial. Hope you had a great time learning some Arabic and learning some new Arabic expressions. Till next time, stay safe, and I look forward to see you in our next tutorial. Ma'a salama.